What is up, everybody? I'm your host of Brunning and Stave here with a quick one for you. But before we get started, be sure to hit like and subscribe. It really helps out the channel. Biden just went on 60 Minutes, and here's the thing. I like to give credit where credit is due, and there were a few parts of the interview where he actually sounded coherent and presidential, so if you have time, I recommend checking out the whole episode for yourself. With that being said, there were a few moments of the interview we can't just let go, so let's get into it.
Mr. President, as you know, last Tuesday, the annual inflation rate came in at 8.3%. The stock market nosedived. People are shocked by their grocery bills. What can you do better and faster?
Well, first of all, let's put this in perspective. Inflation rate month to month was just an inch, hardly at all.
You're not arguing that 8.3 is good news.
No, I'm not saying it is good news, but it was 8.2 or 8.2 before. I mean, it's not, I can make it sound like all of a sudden, my God, it went to 8.2%.
It's the highest inflation rate, Mr. President, in 40 years.
I got that.
Well, that statement would have made sense if we measured inflation in inches, but we don't. And while it might not matter to millionaire politicians like Joe, inflation being at 8.2% actually hurts millions of Americans struggling to buy groceries. And at no point does he ever offer any kind of solution. He just makes it sound like it's not that bad. From here, he just deflects to job creation, which is great, but it doesn't actually address inflation or the cost of goods.
Mr. President, first Detroit auto show in 3 years.
Yeah.
Is the pandemic over?
The pandemic is over. We still have a problem with COVID. We're still doing a lot of work on it. But the pandemic is over. If you notice, no one's wearing masks. Everybody seems to be in pretty good shape.
You heard him right, folks. He said the pandemic is over. Not once, but twice. And even notes that no one is wearing masks in the liberal city of Detroit. This does, however, bring up a lot of questions as far as emergency powers, emergency orders, and all the people who lost their jobs because of them.
What should Chinese President Xi know about your commitment to Taiwan?
We agree with what we signed on to a long time ago, and that there's a one China policy, and Taiwan makes their own judgments about their independence. We are not moving, we're not encouraging their being independent. We're not, that's their decision.
But would U.S. forces defend the island?
Yes, if in fact there was an unprecedented attack.
After our interview, a White House official told us U.S. policy has not changed. Officially, the U.S. will not say whether American forces would defend Taiwan. But the commander-in-chief had a view of his own.
So unlike Ukraine, to be clear, sir, U.S. forces, U.S. men and women, would defend Taiwan in the event of a Chinese invasion?
Yes.
Now, he has said this several times, and just like this incident, the White House has come out and walked the statement back every time. I'm not sure what the disconnect is, but someone should really pull Biden to the side and get everybody on the same page. The last thing the world needs is conflict to break out between China and Taiwan. That's all we got for you today, folks. We will be back later today with another one.